Orca whales have inspired and awed humans for many thousands of years. But did you know there is more than one type of orca whale? These are called ecotypes. An ecotype is a distinct variety that exhibits behavioral, structural, or physiological differences from other members of the species. For example, off the coast of British Columbia, there are several ecotypes, including transient whales and resident whales. Transient whales migrate up and down the coast and specialize in eating marine mammals. Resident whales live in coastal waters year-round and eat fish, primarily salmon. Your job will be to come up with a plausible story or hypothesis to explain why there are so many different types of orca whale, each with their own set of unique traits. To begin, let's think about distribution of a trait in a population. This can be any trait that exists along a continuum in a normal distribution. Keep in mind that not all traits follow this distribution pattern. We are not concerned with those at the moment. In such a scenario, we have fewer individuals with the extreme values of the trait. In this example, small and large size. A moderate amount of individuals with the intermediate values of the trait, smallish and largish, and a lot of individuals with the optimum of the trait, in this case, medium-sized. So how might this distribution change when the population adapts to a new environmental condition? One way that a population can adapt is by narrowing the range of the trait. This is called stabilizing selection. In this mode of selection, the optimum value is selected for and the extremes are selected against. As a result, we see more individuals with the optimum value after the selection event. An example of stabilizing selection is number of offspring born to an individual parent. Too few offspring is a value selected against because not enough of them may be viable. Too many offspring is a value selected against because each individual may not get enough resources from the parent. The optimum is selected for, and we see an increase in the number of individuals who have the ideal sized clutch. A second mode of selection is directional selection. In this scenario, the value range of a trait in the population shifts one direction or the other. We can see that the original population before selection, including some members with an extreme value of the trait. Individuals with one of the extremes have been selected against, while individuals with the other extreme have been selected for. As a result, the entire range of the trait has shifted to the right. It could also shift to the left. An example of directional selection is coloration in peppered moths. Before the Industrial Revolution, the optimum value was a light speckled moth that could blend into the bark of trees. Notice that in this original population, dark moths did exist, just in low numbers. As soot began to build up on trees, those dark moths had an increasing advantage of camouflage in this changing environment. The light moths were no longer camouflaged as well. The light color was selected against and the dark color was selected for. A shift occurred in the range and optimum of this trait. The third mode of selection we will consider is disruptive selection. During disruptive selection, there is selection against the original optimum value and selection for both extremes. After selection, we see a bimodal distribution of the trait. This can have potential interesting consequences for speciation if members exhibiting the contrasting values become reproductively isolated. As an example of disruptive selection, we can look at Darwin's finches on the Galapagos Islands. Pre-selection finches had a mean beak size that enabled them to eat medium-sized seeds. During the selection process, which was strong interspecific competition for the medium-sized seeds, it became a disadvantage to rely on those medium-sized seeds and was an advantage to be able to eat small or large seeds instead. As a result, post-selection distribution is bimodal, showing a population with many members having a smaller beak and many members having a larger beak and less having a medium-sized beak. What traits in the different types of orca whales are the result of each of these modes of selection?